This week, I've received quite a few questions on using Apple Mail and how to customize it a little bit more so that it works better for you. So that's what I've decided to do this week, which is to take it to the next level of using Mac OS Mail in order to manage all your email, because it is a surprisingly powerful application. And once you learn a few of these little tips and tricks that I will show you today, I think you might even consider it as your main email application on your laptop or desktop. Now, remember, this is for Mac OS Catalina. This is not for Mac iOS Mail. I will do another video on that in the future. This is just for Mac OS Catalina, the 2020 edition. So before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by hitting that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please subscribe to my channel. And just one more thing before we get into the nuts and bolts of this video is, if you could help me a little bit by just putting down in the comment section your favorite tip from this week, or indeed from last week, if you watched last week's episode, I'll put a link to that up there. And that will really help me going forward in order to give videos that's going to help you more in the future. Okay, let me take you into my Apple Mail now, and I will show you a few more advanced tricks with Apple Rules and Apple Mail. Okay, so today I'm going to show you a little more advanced usage of your smart mailboxes. And one of the big mailboxes that I use is my Action This Day folder. Now, I actually explained this last week, but what I really want to do is I want to show you this from the perspective of having two Action This Day folders. So I've brought in another account. I brought in my English language account here. So I have the Action This Day folder here, and I've got the Action This Day folder on my demo account, Gmail account. And what I want to do is I want to bring those two Action This Day folders together so that I don't have to go into one and then go into the next one. I want to see them all at the same time. So to do that, we're going to create a new smart mailbox. So we go into here and we go new smart mailbox, which is here. And we're going to call this one Action Today, Action This Day, Action This Day. And what we want to do is we want this is from an account. Message is in mailbox. So there we go, in mailbox. And what we want to do is click on here and we go Action This Day. And we want to add another one. So again, we want message is in mailbox. So we're going to tap on that. And we're going to go down to the FanCorp one, which is Action This Day. And that's it. That's all you need to do this. So you can't contains message to match any. So we have to change that to any. If you remember from last week, if you don't have any of that, then it's only going to pick up ones that are in both, which is not possible. So we've got that set up and we're just going to click OK. So now what's happened is anything that's in my Action This Day is now come into this. So we've got the FES one here, if you can see, FES here, and we've got my Gmail ones here. And this is one of the most fantastic mailboxes that I have. Now you can do this again for your waiting for. So I've got a waiting for one here, and I've got a waiting for one there. So let's just go back up to mail. We're going to go into mailbox, and we're going to create a new smart mailbox. And this time we're going to go waiting for. So, and this time again, we're going to go from message is in mailbox, and we're going to choose, let's have a look. We're going to choose waiting for. So there we go, add that one. Okay. And then we're going to add another point, and then we're going to go message is in mailbox. And again, we're going to go down to the FES one and we're going to add waiting for. Click OK. And now, although I don't actually have anything in my waiting for here, as you can see, nothing in there. And there's nothing in this one either. Oh, yes, there is. There's one waiting there. I don't know why that hasn't actually come in. Maybe it's come in now. No, it hasn't come in now. There's a reason why that's not come in. I don't know why. But anyway, that's maybe that hasn't downloaded yet because I've only just set this up and it's just showing the actual link. So there you go. That's another one that you can do. So you've got your Action This Day, and these are just really useful because then you can just bang, bang, bang. You only have one place to go. Now, one question that I actually received in the comments section last week, which is, how do you, is there any way to color, as you can see, color your tasks from different mailboxes so they actually stand out? So in this case, all my Fancourt ones are colored red and my Gmail ones are not colored at all. So this is another one that you can actually use. So one of the things that we can do here is, to set that up, we have to go into preferences and you go into rules. So we go into preferences and we go into rules. And although the Fancourt one I've actually removed at the moment, so we're going to add a rule. So again, we're going to call this FES color. So I'm going to set that one up and I'm going to go. So again, it's from account this time, and we're going to set this up for Fancorp. And what we want to do, perform the following actions. So what we want to do is set color of message to, and then you can actually set the color. So I'm going to set that as red. You can actually change this of text, which probably doesn't look very good. It's not going to sound look very good, I don't think, but you could do that. And that's really all you need. So if any of the, again, you're doing if any of the following, and set the color of background to red and click OK, and then apply the rules to select email, may change their content, active rules will all be applied. Just apply the rule and that's going to do. Now the thing is, what I've noticed from this is it doesn't naturally start adding them to all the emails. It will start adding them from new emails coming in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create another rule. So just to show you how this, so we're going to have, we'll call this the Gmail rule. And again, I'm going to hate doing this, you know, because it doesn't disappear once you've set it up. What we're going to do is we're going to create, let's see, set color of message. And I mean, there are a number of things that you can actually do here, but we're going to set the color of message. And this time we're going to set that to, say, blue. And click OK. And again, we're going to apply. And that's it. That's essentially all you need to do. So once you've done that, we've got all my FES ones have come up here. If I go into, because it takes a little while to actually set the color, but it will set anything that's coming in now. There you go. It's all set up. So now I can actually use all my, these colors will come up. So blue and yellow might stand out well. And you can actually change the color of the mailboxes if you've got multiple mailboxes coming in. And that's essentially all you need to know. Those are just some of additional tips that I wanted to add in that you can do. Now, just so that those of you who missed it last week, I mentioned about having this up here where you've got these up here and you can do command one and command two. What you can do that is to set that up. I can now say, for example, this one here, I can actually move that up here just by dragging it. Now it's dragged. So I can do command one will take me to my inbox. Command two takes me to action this day. Command three waiting for, and command four is my Steve and Gary Facebook. It is my setup. Now there is one more that I would like to show you, which is regarding VIPs. And let's say you want to set up with your, you want to set up a mailbox specifically, say, for your boss. So you want to create a mailbox for your boss. Now the thing is, if you go and looking down here, you can't actually see how to set up an VIP. But let's just say that Steve Dotto is my boss, and what I can do from here, I can actually set that by saying add to VIP. So you click on the email address, so add to VIPs. When I do that, what happens is you will see that I now get an additional mailbox here, which isn't there when I don't have it. So if I remove Steve Dotto now from my VIPs, you'll see that that disappears. So if you're watching this corner here, I will add Steve Dotto to my VIPs and that will come up. And now all the emails I've got from Steve Dotto will come in here, which is a really, really good way of doing it. Now, finally, there's one more that I want to show you, which is to do with the flagging. Now, flagging really only works if you actually have a rule set up with it. So if I had Brian Tracy, for example, here, so I can flag this particular one. I can call it, let's flag that purple. So in my inbox, you'll see that if I go there, you see that it comes up with a flag on it, but it doesn't do anything. There's no, I mean, I can go into here and I can see flag. So effectively, it can actually treat it as a, if you want to do, you can actually treat this as a action this day if you wanted to. If you didn't want to create an action this day folder, you can just flag them as you come down. But again, when you go, if you went into Mailbox, and you can create some rules for that. So let's do new smart mailbox. And if you just say, go down here, any message, message is flagged, for example, and then you can create some rules around your flagged messages. So there are a few things that you can do with flags if you wish. I don't personally use flags, but they are quite useful if you wanted to use it. So now I've dramatically changed my whole inbox. I've made it colorful. I can do all sorts of things. And so there are quite a lot of things that you can do in Apple Mail that a lot of people don't realize. Now, I should just point out, your rules do not sync across to your iOS device. So if you're setting this up on your laptop, your mail rules are not going to sync across to iOS. I don't know why. Maybe that's going to come in an update in the future iOS and iOS update. I don't know. However, what does sync across is your VIPs. So if you flag or you use VIPs, so if you're using your iPad for mail, for example, and you're using or an iPhone for your mail, then I would recommend that you use flagging for action this day, because that does sync. Your flags will sync, and so will your VIPs. They will sync across. For some reason, mail rules do not sync across. Hopefully that will come. It seems to me to be a great big hole in the whole system, but hopefully that will come across in a future update from Apple. But for now, if you really want to see synchronization, then you can sync your VIP folder and you can sync flags, and those are the things. But the rules that you set up for flags are not going to work across your devices. But at least you can actually set this up here, and then in your iOS mail you can make sure that VIPs will be showing, and you can actually show your flags. So there you go. That's just some quick tips, some additional, a little bit more detailed tips on using Apple Mail. These are really, really good. And if you want to go for all in, and I have gone all in on Apple Mail, it's fantastic application once you get used to it. And like I said last week, I've been using it for over 20 years now, so I've got quite used to the old Apple Mail system. And there you go, that's just what I wanted to give you to this week. I hope you found this useful, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing, and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my Learning Center and is incredible value. And it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, Reminders, and Calendar, into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.